हेलो नमस्कार एंड वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ फ्लैश कार्ड्स। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड इन दिस सेशन आई विल ब्रिंग टू यू द पार्ट सेकंड एंड द फाइनल पार्ट ऑफ करंट अफेयर्स फॉर द मंथ ऑफ मे 2020। तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं विद क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। विच बैंक हैज लॉन्च्ड द विकास अभय टू प्रोवाइड रिलीफ टू एमएसएमई बोरोवर्स हुज बिजनेस एक्टिविटीज आर डिसरप्टेड ड्यू टू कोविड-19 पेंडेमिक। सो गाइज, अंडर दिस स्कीम, अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम विकास अभय, मैक्सिमम ₹1 लाख विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द एमएसएमई ओनर्स एज एडिशनल क्रेडिट, ऑलराइट। एंड दिस प्रोग्राम हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड बाय कर्नाटका विकास ग्रामीण बैंक। सो ऑप्शन ए, कर्नाटका विकास ग्रामीण बैंक इज द करेक्ट आंसर। हु हेडेड द सुप्रीम कोर्ट बेंच विच क्लैरिफाइड दैट फ्रॉम नाउ कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स कैन यूज सरफेसी एक्ट टू रिकवर इट्स लोन थ्रू ऑक्शन ऑफ बोरोवर्स पर्सनल एसेट्स। So guys, this SARFAESI Act was launched in the year, was enacted in the year 2002, and this allows banks and financial institutions to auction the properties of borrowers who failed to repay their loan within the 60 days, right? 60 दिन के अंदर अगर कोई borrower अपना loan repay नहीं कर पाता, तो या loan का कोई भी amount या interest या principal में से कुछ भी portion नहीं दे पाता है, तो सरफेसी एक्ट 2002 के अकॉर्डिंग बैंक्स एंड फाइनेंशियल इंस्टीट्यूशंस के पास पावर है कि वो उसकी प्रॉपर्टीज को ऑक्शन कर सकते हैं। एंड रिसेंटली सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने ये क्लैरिफाई किया है दैट कोऑपरेटिव बैंक्स कैन नाउ यूज सरफेसी एक्ट टू रिकवर इट्स लोन। एंड दिस बेंच, सुप्रीम कोर्ट बेंच वॉज हेडेड बाय जस्टिस अरुण मिश्रा। सो ऑप्शन बी, जस्टिस अरुण मिश्रा इज द करेक्ट आंसर। मिनिस्टर ऑफ फाइनेंस निर्मला सीतारमन हैज लॉन्च्ड रूपी डॉलर फ्यूचर्स एंड ऑप्शन कॉन्ट्रैक्ट ऑन टू इंटरनेशनल एक्सचेंजेस एट गिफ्ट आईएससी। गिफ्ट आईएससी इज लोकेटेड इन गांधीनगर गुजरात, राइट। एंड व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द एक्सचेंजेस, हमें एक्सचेंजेस का नाम बताना है। सो गाइस, दीज एक्सचेंजेस आर बीएसईज इंडिया आईएनएक्स एंड एनएसईज एनएसई आईएफएससी। सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर विल बी व्हाट, ऑप्शन डी, बोथ बी एंड सी। व्हाट इज द न्यू मार्केट बोरोइंग टारगेट ऑफ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट फॉर 2020-21 फाइनेंशियल ईयर 2021 के लिए जो सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट है उसका मार्केट बोरोइंग टारगेट कितना है। सो अर्लियर दिस वॉज 7.8 लाख करोड़, अर्लियर दिस वॉज 7.8 लाख करोड़, नाउ इट हैज बीन इंक्रीज टू ₹12 लाख करोड़। सो ऑप्शन डी, ₹12 लाख करोड़ इज द करेक्ट आंसर। एंड जो वीकली लिमिट है दैट वॉज अर्लियर ₹21,000 करोड़, इट हैज ऑल्सो बीन इंक्रीज टू ₹30,000 करोड़, जो वीकली लिमिट है ऑफ द बोरोइंग फ्रॉम द मार्केट। ऑलराइट, वीकली लिमिट को बढ़ा के 21,000 करोड़ से 30,000 करोड़ कर दिया गया है। एंड फॉर द होल फाइनेंशियल ईयर 7.8 लाख करोड़ से इंक्रीज करके कितना कर दिया गया है, 12 लाख करोड़। राइट, व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ द पोर्टल लॉन्च्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एमएसएमई हेडेड बाय नितिन गडकरी। नितिन गडकरी लोकसभा कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंसी इज नागपुर द सिटी ऑफ ऑरेंजेस। टू हेल्प इंडियन एमएसएमईज बाय रिजॉल्विंग देयर ग्रीवांसेस सपोर्टिंग एनकरेजिंग हेल्पिंग देम। ऑलराइट, सो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एमएसएमई ने एक पोर्टल लॉन्च किया है जो कि एमएसएमई को हेल्प करेगा By resolving their grievances, उनको सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड करेगा, उनको encourage करेगा और उनको हेल्प करेगा। सो द नेम ऑफ द पोर्टल गाइज इज चैंपियंस पोर्टल। चैंपियंस पोर्टल इज द नेम एंड देर इज ऑल्सो फुल फॉर्म ऑफ चैंपियंस। क्रिएशन एंड हार्मोनियस एप्लीकेशन ऑफ मॉडर्न प्रोसेसेस फॉर इंक्रीजिंग द आउटपुट एंड नेशनल स्ट्रेंथ। ओके, लेट मी रिपीट दिस। क्रिएशन एंड हार्मोनियस एप्लीकेशन ऑफ मॉडर्न प्रोसेसेस फॉर इंक्रीजिंग द आउटपुट एंड नेशनल स्ट्रेंथ। So therefore the correct answer is what? Champions Portal. As per the interest subvention on working capital loans for dairy sector scheme for 2021, -% of interest subvention is provided in case of prompt and timely repayment. So guys, under this scheme, 2% interest subvention is provided to the dairy farmers, and on the timely repayment and the prompt repayment, additional 2% will be provided. Additional 2% of interest subvention will be provided to those farmers. So therefore the correct answer is what? Option D, 2%. And the implementing agency for this scheme is National Dairy Development Board, which is located at a place Anand in Gujarat. Recently, Ministry of Finance has exempted companies with a turnover of over dash and involved in only B2B transactions from accepting payments only by electronic modes like RuPay or Bheem UPI under Section 269SU of the Finance Act 2019. So, Ministry of Finance has exempted companies with a turnover of over ₹50 crores. 50 crore से ऊपर का जिनका भी turnover है, उनको exempt कर दिया है from accepting payments only by electronic modes like RuPay or Bheem UPI. which has become the first Indian bank to introduce the video KYC facility for customers opening savings accounts. So RBI ने in the month of January announced किया था that now banks can avail the video KYC facility for the customers, and the first Indian bank to introduce this facility is Kotak Mahindra Bank. Option A, Kotak Mahindra Bank is the correct answer. Kotak Mahindra Bank is headquartered in Mumbai, and MD and CEO of Kotak Mahindra Bank is Mr. Uday Kotak. All right. In its recent monetary policy, RBI has cut its bank rate and marginal standing facility rate too. So recently, guys, RBI की monetary policy आई थी जिसमें repo rate को कम करके कर दिया गया था 4% and reverse repo rate को कम करके कर दिया गया है 3.35%. And the bank rate and marginal standing facility rates are reduced to 4.25%. So option B, 4.25% is the correct answer. And other than this, RBI has extended the moratorium on term loans and working capitals for a further period of 3 months till 31st August. And RBI has increased the group exposure limit of banks to 30% from 25% for a temporary period. And other than this, RBI extended rupees 15,000 crore line of credit to Exim Bank, and it has also given rupees 15,000 crore refinancing facility to SIDBI for 90 days. And export credit facility is extended from 15 months to 1 year. And time period for remittance of payments by importers doubled to 1 year. And other than this, interest on working capital loans have been deferred up to 31st August, and which allowed borrowers to pay the interest in 6 months up to March 2021 instead of a one-shot payment. So these are some announcements that has been made by RBI in its recently monetary policy. Which section of income tax has been amended by the Ministry of Finance to make it easier for offshore funds to relocate fund management to India? So guys, section 9A. Section 9A of income tax has been amended by the Ministry of Finance to make it easier for offshore funds to relocate fund management to India. By what percentage does the FDI inflow increase in India in 2019-20 as per the DPIIT's International System of Calculation? So as per the DPIIT's International System of Calculation, FDI flow increased by 18%. Alright, 18% badke kitna ho gaya hai? $73.46 billion. Alright, $73.46 billion, and it has been increased by 18%. So therefore the correct answer is what? Option A, 18%. Recently, NSE has reduced its annual listing fees by 25% to the SME companies currently listed on the Emerge platform. Emerge platform, ये याद रखेंगे आप लोग कि Emerge platform जो है वो National Stock Exchange का है, alright? Of the exchange to benefit SMEs. When was the Emerge platform launched? So this Emerge platform, guys, was launched in the year 2012. So option A, 2012 is the correct answer. And recently, NSE has reduced its annual listing fees by 25% for the SME companies. Who has been appointed as the US representative to the International Bank for Reconstruction and Development, which is the lending arm of World Bank? IBRD is the lending arm of World Bank by President Donald Trump. Kisko appoint kiya gaya hai? US ka representative to the IBRD. So he is the Indian American lawyer. His name is Ashok Michael Pinto. Ashok Michael Pinto is the correct answer. Who has been elected as an international honorary member to the American Academy of Arts and Sciences? So recently, Professor Shobhana Narasimhan of Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research has been appointed as the international honorary member to the American Academy of Arts and Sciences. Who has been appointed as the Director General of Archaeology Survey of India? So, new Director General of Archaeological Survey of India is V. Vidyavati. V. Vidyavati is the new DG of ASI, and recently ASI ka new building ko inaugurate kiya gaya tha by the Prime Minister of India in New Delhi. Recently, new building of ASI has been inaugurated by the Prime Minister of India, and the new building of ASI is named as Dharohar Bhavan. Nayi building ko kya kehte hai? Dharohar Bhavan. And other than this, Mr. Manoj Ahuja has been appointed as the chairperson of CBSE. He replaced Anita Karwal. And one more appointment you must remember, Mr. Rajendra Kumar, who is appointed as the Director General of ESIC, Employee State Insurance Corporation. Alright. who has been appointed as the new MD of Jammu and Kashmir Bank for 3 years. नए एमडी कौन है जम्मू एंड कश्मीर बैंक के लिए अगले 3 साल के लिए? सो हिज नेम इज ऑप्शन डी जुबैर इकबाल. जुबैर इकबाल इज द न्यू एमडी ऑफ जे एंड के बैंक फॉर द नेक्स्ट 3 years एंड मिस्टर आर के छिब्बर विल कंटिन्यू एज द चेयरमैन. आर के छिब्बर विल कंटिन्यू एज द चेयरमैन ऑफ जे एंड के फॉर द नेक्स्ट 3 years. हु हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज द न्यू सीईओ ऑफ टिकटॉक? सो गाइस न्यू सीईओ ऑफ टिकटॉक इज केविन मेयर. Kevin Mayer is the new CEO of TikTok and he will also continue as the chief operating officer of the parent company of TikTok which is ByteDance. Alright, parent company of TikTok is ByteDance and he will also continue as COO, that is chief operating officer of ByteDance. Who has been appointed as World Bank's new chief economist and vice president? So World Bank's new chief economist and vice president, this question guys is very very important. New chief economist and vice president is Carmen Reinhart. Carmen Reinhart has been appointed as the new chief economist and vice president. World Bank's headquartered in Washington DC and World Bank is headed by Mr. David Malpass. David Malpass is the chief of World Bank and chief economist of IMF is Geeta Gopinath. Alright. Who has been appointed as the national president of FICCI Ladies Organization? FICCI Ladies Organization के national president कौन बने हैं? So option E, Jahanabi Phukan. Jahanabi Phukan has been appointed as the national president of FICCI Ladies Organization. Who will take charge as the chairman of JP Morgan for South and Southeast Asia? So recently Leo Puri has been appointed as the chairperson of JP Morgan for South and Southeast Asia. Who has been appointed as the CMD of Oriental Insurance Company? Oriental Insurance Company is headquartered in New Delhi and the newly appointed CMD of OIC is Mr. S.N. Rajeshwari. Option B, S.N. Rajeshwari is the correct answer. Who has been appointed as the CMD of Power Finance Corporation? Yeh aapne guys suna hoga. So Mr. Ravinder Singh Dhillo. Ravinder Singh Dhillo has been appointed as the CMD of Power Finance Corporation. When is World Press Freedom Day observed? So World Press Freedom Day guys every year is observed on May the 3rd. 3rd May and this year the theme was Journalism. Journalism without fear. Journalism without fear or favor. This is the theme for this year World Press Freedom Day which is observed on 3rd of May. What is the theme of International Day of Midwives 2020 which was observed on 5th of May? 5 May ko observe kiya gaya. So the theme of this year International Day of Midwives was celebrate, demonstrate, mobilize and unite. So option D is the correct answer. Celebrate, demonstrate, mobilize, unite. When is World Asthma Day observed? So guys World Asthma Day everywhere is observed on 5th of May. So the correct answer is what? Option D, 5th of May. And this year the theme was Enough Asthma Deaths. Enough Asthma Deaths is the theme for this year. When is the World Hand Hygiene Day observed? So World Hand Hygiene Day is also observed on the 5th May. Ye bhi 5 May ko observe hota hai and this year the theme was Clean Care is in Your Hands. Clean Care is in Your Hands. What is the theme of World Migratory Bird Day 2020? So guys World Migratory Bird Day jo hota hai wo every year observed hota hai on the second Saturday of May and October. Alright, second Saturday of May and October ko hota hai har saal World Migratory Bird Day and this year it will fall on 9th May and 10th of October. Alright, and the theme for 2020 is Birds Connect Our World. Birds Connect Our World is the theme of World Migratory Bird Day 2020. What is the theme of International Nurses Day? International Nurses Day is observed on 12th of May and this year the theme is Nursing the World to Health. Nursing the World to Health. What is the theme of the World Bee Day? So World Bee Day is observed on 20th May. Yes, it is observed on 20th May and this year the theme is Be Engaged. Option B. Be Engaged is the theme for the World Bee Day 2020. Now what is the theme of International Day for Biological Diversity? So we all know International Day for Biological Diversity is observed every year on the 22nd of May and this year the theme is Our solutions are in nature. Our solutions are in nature is the theme of International Day for Biodiversity 2020. When is the International Missing Children's Day observed? So every year International Missing Children's Day is observed on 25th May. Option C, 25th May is the correct answer. When is the World Hunger Day observed? So World Hunger Day is observed on 28th May, and these are some facts about the hunger in the world. 820 million people do not have enough to eat. 60% of the world's hungry are women. 98% of the world's undernourished live in developing countries, and hunger kills more than AIDS, malaria and TB combined. Alright, so these are some gruesome facts about the hunger. Who has won the Order of Rising Sun, Gold and Silver Rays by the Japan government? So this award has been given to Thangjam Dhawali Singh. Thangjam Dhawali Singh, who is the founder of Manipur Tourism Forum. Manipur Tourism Forum ke ye founder hai. And ये अवार्ड इनको मिला है for deepening the ties between the two countries. Who among the following are the recipients of the Marcus Wallenberg Prize 2020? So guys, this prize is given in the field of forest. अगर कोई person forest के field में अच्छा काम करता है तो उसको Marcus Wallenberg Prize दिया जाता है. And this year the prize has been given to three people: Nicholas C. Coops, Joseph J. Landsberg and Richard H. Waring. So option A is the correct answer. Who has become the first Indian to win the Fed Cup Heart Award? This award has been given by the International Tennis Federation, which is headquartered in London. And the first Indian to win this award is the tennis player Sania Mirza. Sania Mirza has won the Fed Cup Heart Award, which has been given by International Tennis Federation. Which country has named a street in its Tel Aviv city after Rabindranath Tagore to commemorate the 159th birth anniversary of Mr. रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर? सो रविंद्रनाथ टैगोर के नाम के ऊपर तेल अवीव सिटी में कौन सी कंट्री ने एक स्ट्रीट का नाम रखा है? सो द कंट्री इज गाइस ऑप्शन सी इज़राइल. सी इज़राइल इज द करेक्ट आंसर. हु हैज बीन अवार्डेड विद द 2019 अलेक्जेंडर डालरिम्पल अवार्ड? सो दिस अवार्ड हैज बीन गिवन टू मिस्टर विनय भदवार फॉर हिज आउटस्टैंडिंग कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन द इंडियन हाइड्रोग्राफी. इंडियन हाइड्रोग्राफी में इनका कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन बहुत अच्छा है, एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द इंडियन हाइड्रोग्राफर. एंड सो ये प्राइज इनको दिया गया है फॉर द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन इन इंडियन हाइड्रोग्राफर मिस्टर विनय भदवार, अलेक्जेंडर डालरिम्पल अवार्ड. हु हैज बिकम द वर्ल्ड्स हाईएस्ट पेड फीमेल एथलीट इन फोर्ब्स 2020 लिस्ट? सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस लिस्ट, वर्ल्ड्स हाईएस्ट पेड फीमेल एथलीट इज नाओमी ओसाका, हु इज अ टेनिस प्लेयर फ्रॉम जापान. नाओमी ओसाका. Who has become the first Indian to receive the United Nations Military General Advocate of the Year Award? So this year, this award has been given to Suman Gawani. Suman Gawani. Which country will host the 7th edition of the Commonwealth Youth Games 2023? So this country, guys, is Trinidad and Tobago. Trinidad and Tobago will host the 7th edition of the Commonwealth Youth Games 2023. And Trinidad and Tobago capital is Port of Spain. Port of Spain is the capital of Trinidad and Tobago. Now next question is, which country has won the FIDEchess.com Online Nations Cup? FIDEchess.com Online Nations Cup has won by China. Option E, China is the correct answer, and China defeats USA in the FIDEchess.com Online Nations Cup. 2021 Fukuoka Aquatics World Championships will be held in Fukuoka. In which country is this city located? So guys, this city is located in Japan. Option A, Japan is the correct answer. Recently, Ministry of Culture has released an e-book, Professor B.B. Lal, India Rediscovered, to mark the centenary year of this great personality and to honor his excellent work in the field of Dash. So he was a great personality, and he has contributed his work in the field of archaeology. So option A, archaeology is the correct answer. Who is the author of Wuhan Diary, Dispatches from a Quarantine City? So aap sabne is book ka naam suna hoga, kafi zyada controversy mein aa gayi thi ye kitab. So Wuhan Diary, Dispatches from a Quarantine City has been authored by option E, Fang Fang. Fang Fang is the correct answer. Which country has developed I Feel You bracelet to allow users to maintain social distancing as the lockdown is being lifted? So this bracelet has been developed by Italian Institute of Technology. All right. So therefore, the correct answer is what? Option A, Italy. Who is our composer and writer of One Nation, One Voice, Jayatu Jayatu Bharatam Endam? इस एंडम को किसने कंपोज किया है और किसने राइट लिखा है? सो गाइस, कंपोजर ऑफ दिस एंडम इज शंकर महादेवन एंड इट हैज बीन रिटन बाय प्रसून जोशी. सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज शंकर महादेवन एंड प्रसून जोशी. हु इज द राइटर ऑफ द स्टोरी सीरीज कॉल्ड द इकाबॉग? सो दिस स्टोरी सीरीज हैज बीन रिटन बाय द वेरी फेमस जे के रोलिंग हु इज द ऑथर ऑफ द सीरीज हैरी पॉटर. ऑलराइट, सो इकाबॉग भी जेके रोलिंग द्वारा लिखी गई है. सो गाइस, दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन. आई होप यू लाइक इट. सो ये था दूसरा पार्ट ऑफ द मंथ ऑफ मे 2020. फॉर मोर अपडेट्स डू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.